introduce you to the coward lion. I want to introduce you to the coward lion. When we met the scarecrow, we learned that my people perish for the lack of knowledge. When we met the scarecrow, we learned that some of us are using excuses why we can't get to out of a certain location in our life. And sometimes we don't think we can get out of it because we have too many crows around us. We have too many crows around us keep telling us negative things, and we keep singing the crow anthem. No, y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me in here. And so we've been around too many cruel people. We've been around too many rude people. Some people just have some ugly personalities. Y'all ain't saying nothing up here. And we have been around too many weird people. So we learned around the scarecrow that we got to get out from around some crows. I just wonder, are you like Dorothy? Are you giving somebody some good spiritual advice on how can I get off of this pole? Because there is no reason why I should be on the pole. Because Jesus Christ died on the cross. Y'all ain't saying it to me in here. He died on the cross so I don't have to hang on the cross. He died and he rose so I can have the power. So, Dorothy hooked up with the scarecrow and found out that he really do have a brain. They went a little bit further. Somebody say, go a little bit further. She met the Tin Man. Tin Man. I like Tin Man because he hollered for help. He hollered for help. He said, help! Help! Step right up. Be a blessing today. And so many people are coming. I hear Kim Corns hollering over here. he was hollering, help, help. And the reason why they noticed he was in a stuck position is because he was hollering for help. So oftentimes, we don't know how to ask for help. I'm guilty because I don't like asking nobody for help. I'm willing to go without before I ask sometimes for some help. And sometimes God has to put me in a situation. Somebody say situation. And now I'm in the situation, but I wasn't supposed to stay in the situation. And some of us have gotten rusty because too many things are on us, and we have been through too many seasons of our life that we have gotten rusty. Rusty. Some of us are stuck in religion. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Rusty. Some of us don't really understand the word of God in certain areas of our life. Rusty. Some of us are superstitious, and you believe more in your superstition than you do than your spirituality. And some of us just don't trust anybody. We're rusty. And we have to learn how to yield to God's word. So those are the two that we have already met, and now I want to introduce you, Brother Solomon, are you ready? I want to introduce to you today the coward lion. Please pay attention to the monitor for about 3 minutes, and I'll be back to talk to you about the coward lion. Don't y'all go to sleep. Here we go.
It's just a statue. Made of stone, see?
The devil.
I ain't a dummy like me. No, it's stone lion. Can't check you out.
It says, now, we know it but we know this one by heart. And oftentimes we just say it out of routine. But on today, I want to challenge us. I want to challenge us to move a little bit further. Amen? Hebrews chapter 11 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by the elders obtained a good testimony. Somebody say a good testimony. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God.
Yes.
Now, I want you to notice that that word worlds has an S on it. Hallelujah. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of the things which are visible. Oh, God. I'm going to just ask you to jump down a little bit for me and go down to verse 6. It's not on my notes, but let's just jump down to verse 6 right quick. We will read some words on today. But without faith, here it is, I'm not talking about my daughter, but without faith, here it is, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who
diligently.
Huh?
Yeah.
I can't say that today. Seek him. Okay. All right. Let's have some fun in this word. Okay. Because we I want to introduce you to the coward lion. I want to talk to you about the coward lion, because the coward lion, he was hard on the outside, but on the inside, the coward lion was really a kitty cat. Y'all understand me? He acted like he had courage on the outside until he was pushed in a corner and had to really present what was really inside of him. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me up in here. Some of us, have you ever met somebody that seemed like they just as mean as all outdoors? He said, I'm a mean old lion. And it seemed like they just as mean, but they were most of the time, those are the ones that will cry the fastest. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me up in here. You know, we put up this presentation like we are really tough, but really on the inside, when we really get by ourselves, we really are crying and we really need some help. And only way we can get past this thing is that God has to break us down. Break us down from our pride. Break us down. Break us down from our intimidation. Break us down. Break us down from our fear. And see, here it is. In God, God let us know. What world are you in? What world are you in? He, here it is. This is talking about faith in action. Faith in action. I'm really not a real confrontational person. But if you push me, y'all ain't saying it over here. Y'all, I'm just talking about me. Y'all look so guilty. If you push me, then therefore I will show you that I'm not really the coward you think that I am. Huh? Y'all ain't gonna say that up here. I'm as nice as I can be. I would do anything for anybody, but just don't push me past my limit. Y'all ain't gonna say that. So I have to learn. I had to learn. I'm having to learn. I had to learn. I'm having to learn that I have to protect this line. This line. Y'all hear that? This lion, so I will not cross the line.
Yeah,
y'all know some of y'all, Did somebody push y'all a little bit too far? Huh? Mm-hmm. Y'all ain't been praying all of your life. Huh? Look at your neighbor and ask your neighbor, are you still praying? you still praying? So now I'm going to ask you, in your life, have you felt like the coward lion? Huh? Yeah. Did you notice? Did you notice that when Dorothy and the Tin Man and the Scarecrow met the lion, he was in a stuck position too? Everybody that Dorothy come in contact with, they were in a stuck position.
Oh, y'all ain't gonna say that nothing here.
God have called us to get outside of these walls so we can help people to get out of the stuck position. But the reason why we hadn't made it far enough is because some of us are still stuck.
Oh, just grab your neighbor by the hand and ask your neighbor, are you stuck? Oh, if y'all don't, y'all better talk loud to me, because you know I'm gonna start hollering in a minute. Praise God. I just wanna know. Dorothy, she came in contact with the Scarecrow. She helped him. Look at somebody and ask your neighbor, are you a Scarecrow?
Are you a Scarecrow?
And then she went a little bit further, because you know the whole thing was Dorothy was eating with her family, and all of a sudden, a storm came.
Took her out of her comfort zone, put her in a place called Oz, that she had no point of reference or no guideline to get to the place where she went. But somebody told her that she needed to find a wizard.
Yes.
Oh, y'all missing that. Somebody told her that she needed to find a wizard. And because somebody told her that she needed to find a wizard, it ignited something that was in her. Oh, I come to tell somebody today, whatever you're going through, I come to tell you a good news. Oh, because it is our Savior Jesus Christ who died on the cross for your sins and mine, and he had died up.
Today. Mm-hmm. Because he said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. I never asked you to be them. I just used them to ignite what was already in you. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. But you keep hanging around these crows. Y'all ain't saying that up here. You keep hanging around these crows and keep telling you what you can't do. You got to get off the pole. And some days you know somebody that's really dancing on the pole. Y'all ain't saying that up in here. Some of y'all know some people that got some handicaps.
Right.
Then you gotta have assurance.
Yeah.
Oh God. Listen, this is not a seasonal battle.
Right.
Oh God. This is a daily, a daily battle.
Yes,
huh?
Right.
Some days I feel like I'm a strong lion. Y'all ain't saying it over here. Some days I have a roar. Just look at your neighbor. Yeah. Y'all say the snare out on that thing. Yeah. Look, I'm a real lion. But here, it's a. Sometimes I just crack myself up. I'm sorry. Now faith is the confidence in what we hope for. And if you're going to have confidence, you have to have assurance that God is going to do it.
Yeah.
Because now you see it, but you don't see it. Mm-hmm. That makes sense?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm going to be an entrepreneur, I got to see it in my spirit before I see it manifest in the natural. That chair you sitting in was somebody's idea.
Right. Right. Yes.
And because of their idea, they wrote a blueprint.
Yeah.
And because of the blueprint, there was a manifestation of the idea.
Yes.
That will walk with me. This is what the ancients were commended. Listen, everybody God used had to have faith. Everybody God used had an excuse why they couldn't do it. Abraham? Why God didn't give Abraham a son when he was 22? He let that joke get old and rusty. By faith, we understand that the universe was formed at God's command, verse 3, so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible.
Right, right.
Oh God, here you go. The first thing God started doing in Oz with the Wiz, he was putting together a team. Y'all hear me? He will put them, all of them were different. All of them was different. Y'all still with me?
Yes.
All of them was different. And none of them had the same talent.
Right.
Ten man, excuse was he didn't have a heart. The crow, scarecrow,
yes.
Excuse was he didn't have a brain. The cow and lion, he said, I ain't got no courage. And God started putting this team together.
Right, right.
So whatever your excuse is, y'all will follow me. Whatever your excuse is, I got you.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Because you don't have a brain, but I do. Y'all ain't saying that up here. You don't need a heart because I have a heart. I just wonder if there are any hearts in the house today. Now, if you want Can I tell y'all something?
Yes, go ahead.
Can I be honest with y'all?
Amen.
I try to be transparent with y'all. I'm scared. Mm-hmm. God called me.
Yes, yes.
To preach this gospel.
Amen.
I'm scared. Mm-hmm. I don't want to mess up.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Can I just tell y'all the truth?
Yeah.
I was scared to be your pastor.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great responsibility.
Yes, yes.
Because I know that there are some things that is jacked up in my life. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. I'm just going to say what y'all want me. I'm going to say what y'all are going to say to me. It's already framed. It's a done deal.
Yeah, yeah.
God, when God created you, when he formed you in your mother's belly, he already had a plan for you. And the enemy's job is to get you off the plan. So let's go to Deuteronomy 31. Somebody shout, stand!
Stand!
Somebody shout, stand!
Stand!
Somebody shout, stand!
Stand!
My first point was faith in action. Listen, when the Bible tells you to stand, he's telling you don't lose your confidence. Y'all with me? Can I teach this lesson today? He really wants you to have confidence and an assurance in what I have been teaching you. You've been in class all your life. It's called life class. It's not Oprah's class. It's your life. You're in a class. So it's faith in action. You can't tell me. Now, here's what James had a difference with some of those that had faith. You say you have faith, but you're not doing nothing. You have faith, but you're not doing nothing. Oh, I believe I'm going to get in that car.
Yeah.
I ain't moved. I'm going to that car.
Yeah.
I ain't moved. I have enough faith that I'm going to get in that car. Guess what I got to do? I got to start walking toward the car.
Yeah, right.
When I start walking toward the car, here it is. When I start walking toward the car, there may be some things in my way.
Right,
right. But I gotta get to the car. Huh? Right. Can't stay here all day with y'all. Well, what am I gonna do to get to the car? Now Moses is getting ready to transition on. Okay? Moses is gonna die. And what did God tell you? To kill you. What did God tell you that you're gonna die today? He tell you, you got 5 days and I'm going to take you home. What would you do different? Here it is. God done told Moses, I'm going to take you home. He said, but I need you to get the next man in place. Here it is. You got to help somebody else get in position. The whole reason why Dorothy ended up in Oz is because there were 3 people that needed her.
Yeah, right,
If there was not a need, she never would have got caught up in the storm.
Yeah.
I don't wish I could get this word. Let's see what Moses told Joshua.
Here.
Y'all with me? He said, God told him, be strong and
courageous.
Some people are going to say, you crazy.
Right.
Faith. You talking about moving in faith. You a little crazy sometimes. Sometimes you're not gonna have faith every day. Some days fear will win. But when fear wins, you can't let him have the last word. Y'all be telling him up here. He said, be strong and courageous. Do not be, here it is, afraid. Here it is, I like this. Don't be afraid or terrified because of them. Who is them? There will always be somebody to tell you,
amen.
You ain't good enough. But you gotta have faith. Is a what? Substance of what?
Faith.
Yeah. What the thing hope for is what? Confidence.
Right.
And the evidence of things what?
Not seen.
Here it is. Then he said, for the Lord hears, your God goes with you.
Yes.
Oh, I wish I would get this. He will never leave you. Sister Mary, he will never leave you. Glory, he will never leave you.
Yes,
oh, God. Father. Somebody was getting me. Paul, he will never leave you. Maybe brother Ritter will get this. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Oh, God. So when that doctor said, I don't know how you walked up in here. When you had that heart attack a few weeks ago. God said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. We didn't call you to get the blood out of the man. We just trusted in the Lord. That was God.
Everybody died,
right.
But them two.
Huh.
Yeah.
So let me show you this last thing before I leave. Now he's in position. Go to Joshua chapter 1. Y'all can look up here. Once I will get it. Now I need you to be strong. Faith in action, you got to stand on the word of the Lord, and now you got to be strong. Now you're going to become a conqueror. Joshua didn't throw down no rod, and it didn't turn to no snake. He didn't hit no rock, and no water came out of it. Those all was what Moses was anointed to do. But Joshua didn't do that. Joshua was anointed to put things in order and fight. He wasn't trying to be Moses. Who am I talking to up here? You can't do everything your mama did. I can't do everything my daddy did. He was anointed for that.
Right.
I got to walk in my anointing.
That's right.
Y'all ain't standing up here. But because of his anointing, he gave me the strength and the faith and the confidence to walk in my anointing.
Amen.
He summoned me. Oh, y'all ain't standing up here. Look what Joshua said. Joshua, he told God, told Joshua, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. Confidence, faith in action, stand. You got to be strong. If you're going to be a leader, you got to be strong.
Right.
I don't care what you're up against, you got to be strong.
Right.
You're going to have to be courageous. You're going to have to know that God called you. He summoned you.
Yes.
He said, no one will be able to stand against you. That's why I don't go after my critics like I used to. Y'all ain't standing up in here. That's why I ain't got time to get in an argument with you. Because God told me he gonna be with me. He said, I never leave you nor forsake you. Look what he said here. He said, you're going to have to be committed. Courage. You're going to have to obey the word of the Lord. Courage. You're going to have to understand when you don't understand. Courage. It will be revealed to you.
Yes.
Courage. You got to agree with what God say, and you have to move with the power of agreement.
Yes.
Y'all ain't saying nothing here.
Yes.
Courage. You got to be willing to grow.
Yes.
Courage. Yes. And last but not least, you have to execute the plan. You have to execute the plan. You got to be committed. You have to obey. You have to understand. It will be revealed. You have to agree. You have to grow. And you have to execute. Courage. You have to execute. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible. But without faith, it is impossible. But without faith, faith and excuses don't go together. But without faith, it is impossible. My conclusion, is there anything too hard for God? You've been set back for a set up. I know you was a mean old lion. I know you done hung around some crows. You were stuck in the junkyard for a season. But now, did you notice that the lion was in a nice place? But he was stuck. I wish y'all watch movies like I watch movies. I can sermon out everything I see. He was in a nice place, but he was stuck, Paul. He was stuck. He wasn't like the scarecrow in a dead garden. He wasn't like the tin man around a bunch of pile of junk. He was in a nice place. But he couldn't move. You gotta have growth. If you want your hair to grow, you gotta cut them bad ends off. You want a nice pedicure? You gotta file down them cones.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Oh, God. Stand on your feet. Oh, God. Willing to grow. You can't stay stuck in the same mindset. You can't stay stuck around things that are not growing. You can't stay stuck being around messy people. You can't. You can't. If you want to grow, your conversation got to change on Facebook. If you want to grow, you got to watch what you put on Instagram.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. If you want to grow, you got to do read more books in the direction that you're going.
Right.
If you want to grow, you have to lose some little bit of sleep. God is looking for people that are willing to be busy about his business. You got to commit to being consistent. I come against the spirit of procrastination. How bad do you want? Father God, lift your hands. Father God, I thank you for that word of today. Some of us look like we're so tough. But really, really, God, we're so soft on the inside. Strengthen us. to have balance in life. Thank you, God, for the word today to let us know that we are strong. We have to be courageous. And we have to diligently seek after you, God. Help us to walk by faith. Gosh, I don't know why. Help us to walk by faith. Help us to walk by faith and not by sight. Some of us have been caught up in what we physically see. Help us to walk by faith. Ignite our fire. For when the shift comes, we are ready for the shift in our life. Help us, God, to lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge you, God, and you will direct our path. For it is in you that we live, move, and have our being. For too many years we have felt like the cowards. For too many years we felt like we were less than. For too many years we have put up with things we didn't have to put up with. For too many years, God, we've been sitting in this old mess of stuff for too long. Now, God, show us how to get out of this. Show us how to grow out of this. Show us how to commit to your will. Help us, God, to obey your word. Help us, God, to understand your word. Reveal unto us your voice. God, I know we can agree with you, God. Help us to agree with one another, God. Father, help us to grow. Help us to execute the plan that you have for our life. Thank you in advance for what you're going to do. In the name of Jesus, I give you all the praise and the glory.